out. Exactly. Like, this is crazy. Like, why would we make this happen?
Exactly.
She's already so safe anyway.
As soon as you try to punish her, you're going to get hit with a gut stun. Or she can. So, Mila was already good. We already know this. Obviously, the tackle glitch that was, you know, going around in DOA5 was taken out of the game that wasn't supposed to be there.
Yep.
But we all thought that the fact that, you know, with the break hold now, 7K fully charged used to give you the guaranteed critical burst.
Yep.
Now, because you have access to the break hold, there's no guaranteed launcher from there. But you can actually do two safe throws and let them hit the ground and do a down throw guaranteed 100%. She is one of the only characters in the game that can take advantage of that like that.
So I was talking to Master just yesterday, and for me personally, I think over the life of this game, Mila's going to maybe sneak into the top five best characters.
100%. I agree. It was kind of questionable because, again, when a game first comes out, you don't really know what is really going on as far as where the characters fall. Again, we didn't know Christie was as good as she is. We all thought that she may have fallen into B tier, obviously from S tier. But, you know, she turned out to be a really, really good character once we started to break her down. So this is going to be good, man.
Yeah.
Memphis Legends. This is no button check.
And Mila's down punch is plus one on hit.
Plus one. So that's going to go a long way in his matchup. He needs to access that down punch in order to get his frame advantage.
Yeah. And that's the thing. Like, one combo from Mila already took almost half life. His next combo could finish it.
All right, he's going to get the option select. Nice.
Great. And that's the first great we've seen all day.
Oh, yeah.
So you know Memphis Legends is here to play. Da-da.
So Shakes is this a...
I can't tell. Shakes has controller issues. I'm not sure. Can't tell from this button movement.
And this is why we button check.
So maybe this was a button check the entire time. We just didn't know it.
Yeah, maybe Memphis thought that he was going in, and that's probably why Shakes wasn't moving.
No, it looks like they're going
in. No, they're playing now. Okay.
Okay. Colin B. Shakes needed a breather.
Yeah, he was like, man, I just got graded. I need to actually step back real quick.
Yeah. And it's interesting from Colin B. Shakes. Like, he's doing that 7K, but he's not following up with the mid-punch.
Oh, yeah.
This could have put him into the wall there.
Memphis Legends has very good movement as well. Mila has one of the best backdashes in the game. She gets across the screen really fast with her backdash and her wave dash.
Yeah, I think the only real true weakness from her is just the fact that her walk speed itself is a little slow.
Very slow,
you can get around that by doing the Korean backdash.
Exactly. If you use the Korean backdash and also as well as the wave dash, she can move really, really fast.
Yeah.
All right, so there's a no whiff punish. Oh, my God, we got a pause.
I don't know about that. Who paused? Who did?
Who paused? I don't know. It's already over. There's no way to figure it out now.
Yeah, they're going to play through it, which I respect. I mean, at this point, they're just going to play through it. Get it done. And it looks like Memphis Legends is almost in control of this.
Memphis Legends looking to close that. Here's the option select, standing kick, low throw, and he is dead.
Yeah.
So Shakes obviously thought laying on the ground at that point was the safest option. Maybe not sure that, you know, not aware that Mila actually has the option select on the wall, but if you're going to lay on the floor, make sure that you're ready to get your back broken because she has the option select.
Yeah.
When you tech up from that, she actually has plus advantage.
Yeah,
so
that's why I'm saying she's just a super dangerous character.
Oh, yeah.
And I think just, you know, as more people figure out the fact that she has that option select, you'll see more players playing her, and then we will also see the fact that she will be considered a top five character.
Right. Mila, I mean, obviously, you know, I'm a Mila sub some days. Some days I'm a Mila sub. Some days I'm a Rig sub. I don't know what character I play secondary at this point, but obviously I play Hayate. Mila, I feel very strong. Again, I played her for a long, long time. I played her for 5 years before this game came out when we did DOA5. So, you know, I know Mila's potential. I know she's very good. And again, Memphis Legend recognized him as one of the better Mila players in the community. He knows what this character can do as well. Otherwise, he wouldn't be using her right now. So, she's very good. And also, she has, you know, she just got everything. She's, in my opinion, one of the more perfect characters in the game. She's not super slow, but she's not super fast. She's very balanced. She's got an offensive hold, something that a lot of characters in the game lack. Not only does she have an offensive hold, but it goes under highs. Okay, so it's she's just a very good character.
She's
got the opposite
selection
on the wall. Complete character, 100%.
Yeah, and I expect to see her, like, in a lot of top eights throughout this World Championship.
Right. And again, another thing that is new to DOA 6, the stagger escape was removed from the game. That actually changes a lot as far as the way the game is played. So when you're going up against a Mila and you're going up against a Christie, you know, stagger escaping was very important because of the fact that they're so fast and their stuns last for so long, you want to try to do whatever you can to get out of stun. In this game, you have to use break hold. You have to fuzzy guard out of stun to get out. So it's really different this time around. No punish on the fatal stun there by Memphis Legends. Oh, nice combo.
But, and because he didn't punish...
Look at what happened. It's exactly why it's so important to punish. Nice hole by Shakes. That's unsafe again.
This could be a problem if Memphis
the option select.
Yeah. And it does damage because it doesn't suffer from any, like, you know, like if you've done a combo, usually.
Ooh, whoa, that's dead. Nice. That was a great quarter circle back throw by Memphis Legends to close that. That was high counter, too.
I like the crush there. He recognized the high punch is coming his way. He said, you know what, let me get this 2P combo.
So right now it looks like Memphis is having a hard time chaining together his stun setups at this point. It looks like Chinx is getting out a lot of them. Oh, that's going to hurt. He's going to break long. No, he doesn't. Okay.
Saving the meter.
Still early. Nice. Gets the back turn four grab there. There's look the sway we were just
there
talking
it
about. It's so good.
So good. So good. So good. I like what we're seeing from Memphis. He's just fighting his way back in, staying within striking distance to take the round. But as I say that, this is the setup you always want to be against because you have to guess. It's a complete guess. You don't have a wake-up kick. You just got to guess.
Yep. There's that new forward grab by Chrissy that they put in this game. They actually took her other forward grab, and I believe they made it her back throw now.
Yeah.
So.
And I like it. I like the new animation.
No, I do. I love the new animation as well. It reminds me of Jan Lee's old forward grab, or the one he has now.
And even he got a new forward grab as well.
Yep. I think it's actually it's a 10-frame grab. It might be quarter circle back grab. Or no, quarter circle back grab is the one where he kicks you in the face. I forget what input. I think it's back forward grab or something like that.
Might be.
Yep. All right, so there's the launcher there. He's going to go for the machine gun punches. Standing kick. He's got to get up from that. He's got to get up. I think at this point he realizes, I got to get off the floor.
Yeah. All right, I hope so. Because he's going to keep losing rounds.
Nice. Gets the mid-kick hold there.
He's not breaking that, and that's a ton of damage.
All right, there's the forward punch. Let's see if Combi Chase can get something started. Misses the combo. He's not taking advantage of his bound at all. He's not using the Ace plus KKK in stun. I mean, in launchers. He's got to use it to get that bound.
And that's, if we notice, the thing about Mila that's so dangerous is the fact that when she gets a chance to throw punish you, it puts you in a situation where you're like -7.
Right.
You know? And you just got to guess. You're at a disadvantage each time. It's crazy.
So I believe that was 2.
That was 2-0?
That was 2, yep. That was first to 2. So
Memphis
Lex is moving on in the winner's
again.
Bracket. Yeah. He's like, am I playing again? Like, do I got to give this man hands again? Like, what's going on?
I want more.
Obviously, Shakes is not out of the event. He's going to be going to lose bracket as well. We're probably going to see.